You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Johnson.
Maria Menounos and Bing.com present live from the Mixology 101 bar at the Farmers Market in Los Angeles, California, and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies, this is AfterBuzz TV's Dancing with the Stars edition. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV for Dancing with the Stars.
Welcome. Bing is for doing, and we are doing week three of Dancing with the Stars for AfterBuzzTV.com. Welcome. I am Rachel Zalis, joined by my gorgeous panel over here. Introduce yourself, ladies.
I'm Robin Antin.
And I'm Jackie Miranne.
Yes, we are going to be talking, breaking down everything you need to know about Dancing with the Stars. Check it out at AfterBuzzTV.com. iTunes, give us your comments. You can tweet us. We'll answer all your questions. Yes. At Rachel Zalis.
Robin Antin, PCD, as in Pussycat Dolls.
And Jackie Miranne, solo, just Jackie Miranne. Just Jackie.
And once again, we are at Mixology at Farmers Market, where all the celebrities and dancers, everyone comes after the show to party and hang out and come chat with us. Yes. So you'll be seeing a lot more interviews later in the show. But before we do that, let's break down.
Before we get started, I just want to make sure that everyone knows, when the show first started just now, my head was down and I was literally holding onto my boobs, and I just want everyone to know that I wasn't just like playing with my boobs, but I was just trying to pull my dress up. Month, they grow like five sizes.
Yeah, Jackie and I wish we had that problem.
So if I keep doing this, that's why. Because eventually it's going to be another kind of a show,
let's
if you know
Jackie,
what I mean.
Let's
we
just
all
hold her
feel
up.
So bad for you.
Let's hold her up.
Let me help you fit your boobs in your dress.
I think this might be one of the highest rated shows.
It's called Dancing with the Naked Stars.
All right, enough about us. Okay, let's get on to the dancers and the celebrities. Now, tonight was a big night. It was theme night. A year in their life that really meant something to them, and a song that went along with that. Now, started off big, Jack Wagner. He found out just recently that he had a daughter that he didn't know about. She came and found him backstage at the concert, and this was a big surprise, but he also says one of the biggest, most exciting, amazing things that's happened in his life.
Absolutely, and I was actually just on the red carpet with him, ladies, and believe it or not, of all things, his daughter is a ballroom dancer.
Oh my God, you're kidding.
So she
Seriously?
Was literally, she is an expert. She was talking jive and all of her favorite dances, what she likes, what she didn't like. They actually both didn't like the same dance. She was giving him critiques all week long with Anna. He said he was being told what to do by two women this week.
Oh. Not a bad position to be in.
Listen to the ladies.
He must be loving that.
Although he likes blondes, right?
He does.
Right. Yeah. I'm sure he loves you and you. Well, he doesn't like me.
Well, it's funny because people sometimes tell me I look like Heather Locklear. And last week I was like, yeah, Jackie, do you think he was looking at me?
He was scoping her out. Heather Locklear or no Heather Locklear? He was giving you a look.
Yeah. Jack, my number is 310. I kind of think he's sexy. I mean, listen, I had a crush on him when he was on Soap Opera.
Yeah.
So, I mean, to me, like, his picture was on my locker.
Yeah.
So it's kind of crazy.
No, he's definitely a handsome man.
And he's really nice, too.
Yeah.
He's really nice on the right. Like, some stars, you know, they come and they go, he saw me. He was like, oh, let's do our interview, you know. Like, he's really considerate, nice guy from what I've seen of him.
Oh, that's great.
That's just even
Love
better.
To hear that.
He's hot and he's nice.
Now, what did we think of his dance, though? I mean, he started out with a lot of pelvic thrusting, I gotta say.
He was into the pelvic thrusting.
And it was good. I think it set the tone for the night because the judges gave him 24, you know, 3/8. That's a big thing to start off with on round three.
And we always say this, it's hard to go first, right?
Absolutely.
And he set, this is only week three, people.
Yeah.
And the dances, the lowest score was what? A 24 this week for week three? That's like unheard of.
It's insane.
So I think he had something to do with setting the tone.
Yeah.
Tonight.
Should I start?
Yes, please.
This is what I have to say. No.
Uh-oh, Robin.
Okay, you know, I
bring it.
Say it like it is. I'm the dancer on the panel. I'm always going to, you know, give you my real critique on the technique and but what I have to say about Jack. First of all, I was so shocked. I thought that he was going to be gone. I thought that this was it. This was it for him this week.
Right.
And I was so shocked. You know, he starts off with his little guitar thing and then jumps off, and I mean, he had like this movement and this way that his body was moving his hips, and he just had this, he danced with ease. He was
hips don't lie.
That's right. To me, he was the one of maybe out of two that had massive progress this week, and I was really impressed and really happy for him because he seems like such a nice person.
Well, the judges felt the same way as you. Like, yeah, they all thought like he showed dramatic improvement. I think that's what the show's about.
Right.
It is.
I wonder though, if when you're driven from that emotional place, I wonder how much that amped him up for his dance. Like, I wonder if he does make it through to next week, if he'll continue to improve, or if he just, you know, because sometimes when you have that emotion driving you.
It's true.
So I'm just curious to see. I hope he continues to improve.
That is what performing is all about. You know, you're driven by emotion and by the things that have happened in your life, I think, with any kind of performance, whether it's dancing, singing, acting. And I hope that they all take this experience this week and take it into their following weeks, you know.
I think that's why this week did so well, is because there was so much emotion and backstory, and it gave the dancers a reason, like a motivation for their dances. I mean, Maria, who's next with Derek.
My God.
I don't think a lot of people realize that she didn't grow up with a lot of money. She worked with her parents as a janitor in nightclubs where all the other kids were dancing and having a good time. It was a very different life, and like, this is her chance to like have that experience finally. And I gotta say, the guy sitting next to me kept going, "Damn, she's working that dress. Woo, she is working that dress."
I know, it's so great. Well,
who's definitely a crowd pleaser. And I gotta say, I think there was like a little, I saw some tongue lips crazy, girls.
There were legs. Honestly, those moments in the dance, I was like, the crowd I was in went in the back there, we're all watching together, they went crazy. Like, oh my God, did they just kiss? Like, I mean, those moments were crowd stopping, but also just her technique, the way she's transformed. It's only week 3, and last week I said she went from a celebrity to being a dancer.
Yes.
This week she went from being a dancer to being like an amazing dancer.
An amazing dancer. I told her that she looked like one of the professional dancers on the floor, and the way that she moved her body, you know, we've been working together just on the kind of just like feeling her body, you know, it's like this sort of, it's a connection between your, you know, with yourself, really. I mean, once you get with Derek, obviously he's you know, he's hot, he's all that, but he's also like, he helps you feel comfortable, but you have to feel comfortable with yourself.
Right.
And I've helped her find that within herself, so when she moves, and even the little things, just like, you know, she had to do this one thing with her arm, and just, I just said, you know, it's not about just like touching your body, it's like,
I was just gonna say, I love that you keep touching your boobs.
I just told her, every time you do that, it's sort of like you have to take this kind of breath, you know what I mean? Which is like what you do when you're in the bedroom and you're feeling hot, you know, it's like you're
breathing. Well, Len said this dance was ballroom meets bedroom.
Absolutely.
The funny thing is, when Maria was first doing the show, she had to fill out a form with questions, and one of them is, what's the dance you're most intimidated by? And it was the rumba, because she's a tomboy.
Yeah.
She's not particularly like into being like the sexy, even though she's so gorgeous.
Yeah,
and
right.
It's amazing that the one dance she chose as being the scariest is one that she absolutely killed.
She reminds me of like an athlete, you know, in the way, like her body and the way that she is, like, because she has that toughness about her. But what I love about her on this show is that it's unexpected, because, you know, she's so cool, and she has this crazy laugh, and she's just so, you know, like, she's not inhibited. Her personality is like just like one of the guys in a way. You know what I mean?
WrestleMania. And,
yeah,
you need
exactly.
to say more you know, than
and,
that. I mean,
and then she's
the night
like,
before, she's throwing chicks down in the ring, and
right.
then she's, you know, sexing up and gyrating all over Derek.
But also elegant. You know, like, let's not forget that. The way that she moves, she's so graceful. And I don't even think that she ever knew that she even had that, you know. So I think that, I mean, honestly, to me, she deserved all 10s. She got great scores, but I would have given her...
27.
Yeah.
Amazing score.
Yeah.
I mean, for the good first part of the show, she stood in a league all her own, in
true,
my
yes,
opinion.
Absolutely.
I really think so.
Yeah.
For a good part of the show.
Okay.
And
well,
that's
the
great.
Next dancer, Gladys Knight. That woman just makes me smile.
Yeah,
I love her. I mean, she honored the Pips. just, you know, like, she's such a part of history and, like, music and culture in our lives. And she goes out there. She's lens-headed. He's like, she's my age. She goes, I don't think I could get out there and do what she's
doing. Exactly.
Amazing. So I'm so inspired by her.
And didn't she look beautiful tonight?
Gorgeous.
I thought she looked the best she's looked
in
this competition.
That dress was gorgeous on her.
And Tristan, she said Tristan actually does have a little bit to do with it, and then she takes over. When you're the female celebrity, you know, it's different when it's a female pro choosing the costumes, choosing the all the details. But when it's a man,
exactly.
He's choosing that costume, you know.
Yeah.
So she said she had enough to do with it. But I thought she looked great. Apparently, she lost a shoe size through this competition.
Are you serious?
How did I lose a shoe size?
Because when you lose weight everywhere. So, you know, when you're heavier, your feet are... they're heavier. I mean, it sounds strange, but you lose.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
She was a big improvement because Glenn had given her a 5 the week before, and she got 3/8.
Yeah, that was amazing.
Huge.
And I also love that, you know, he's such a boy. Like, I feel like on the show, he's one of the boys. Some of them are more men. I mean, you know, he's a man, but he just has that more sort of boyish quality.
Right.
And then she's this, like, total woman. I mean, you know, that we've all known for years and years and years. And so to see them together was so beautiful because it was like there was no age difference. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
And that's when
you
know it's
working. That's a good point. Yeah.
You know?
Like, you never feel like she's
older.
The older woman with the younger guy.
Yeah.
Such a nice ease between the two of them, which I really enjoy.
It was like a beautiful collaboration. And I think that that's something that, you know, in partner dancing, it's great to know that you never really need that guy to, like, I need to look perfect with him. It's like, you know, I mean, just for even going out there and learning partner dancing out there, you know, when they have partner dancing classes, it's like there's so many different people you would never expect as your partner. There's big giant guys or skinny guys or short guys, you know what I mean? It's cool.
Well, I'm curious to know, these contestants seem like they all have great chemistry with their partners, but sometimes the partners don't get along with the contestants.
Usually Max.
Right.
Let's call it for what it is.
And that has to affect dance when, right? I'm sure the chemistry all has to kind of be there. Or can you totally hate each other and then get on the floor?
Yeah, I mean, you know, because dancing is a
hate
love.
Hate is passion.
Yeah.
That's true.
It's a love-hate relationship. It's like, you know, it's just, I think that it's great because it brings out that passion and that, you know, fierceness when you're putting it together. So by the time you get on the dance floor, it makes it work. I think if it's all just perfectly love, then you might be kind of boring. I think everyone kind of has little fights. You know what I mean? We may not even see it all. We'll hear it tonight.
There's a little bit of drama coming.
I think it's getting more and more passionate, more and more like, you know, like intense.
Well, certainly not boring is Thriller.
Oh my
don't
God!
Don't get enough. Oh, beat it.
Rashawn
and Afro. I mean, that guy got out there and just worked that floor. It might not have been the samba that Len wants,
right?
But the samba that's an audience we want, big time.
No, I just think that, I mean, you know, like, obviously we have to talk about Michael Jackson here, and, you know, I think that he really, truly would have made him so proud to the point of, you know, beyond. I mean, when he grabbed his crotch, I was like, hello.
Were you getting a little...
Yeah, I was. I mean, I'm like, he's a young boy, but my goodness. But he...
Talk to your boobs again.
Yeah, I did. I'm like, woo! He grabbed his crotch.
Rashawn. I don't have the same effect when I do that.
I have to think of something else.
By the way, if you guys are listening to this on iTunes, you got to check these ladies out. I mean, first off, they took a camera off of me so you guys can see me and my mom. But you got to see these girls. Dare I say it, boobs?
Yeah.
Go to AfterBuzzTV.com.
Are we getting Phil hot and bothered?
boobs are the big talk.
We're Phil's angels tonight.
Phil's blushing.
We're talking a lot
that
about
it. That is an honor I'm glad to take.
That's good.
Back to
Rashawn's crotch.
Back to his outfit. I think he got Jack Wagner's recycled suit for
next week, I mean, I really would want to see Jack in something a little bit more hip, you know?
Yeah.
That we'll move on from Jack, but I was thinking that. It's a little like, those colors kind of make me nervous.
Well, with Rashawn last week, he said he was either going to go the white socks, Michael, and like that whole look, or the 70s flare thing. And we know which one he chose.
Yeah.
I don't know if I love the outfit, to be honest.
Yeah.
It was really costumey for me.
It was.
But he's still, when he starts dancing, come on. I mean, it's just, I do, I was worried the whole time watching what the judges would say.
Yeah.
Because it is so screaming Roshan, which is, I think, a good thing for viewers, but I'm waiting for the judges to really lace into him.
And the fact that Len and Carrie only gave him 8s and Bruno the 9, but they gave him 8 shows that they appreciate that he's a great dancer and does all the Michael Jackson stuff, but that's not exactly the samba that they're looking for.
I know. It was really, like, off of everything about the show, but it was so good.
Crowd pleaser.
Yeah, he's a total entertainer.
I always
entertainer.
Go for crowd pleaser.
Exactly. I think it's we have a secret crush on the panel. We love you, Roshan.
And he told us on the red carpet, ladies, a secret that he thought they talked about on the show, but they didn't. Oh. About his
Tell us,
more.
Jackie.
He told us so much about how he got a pair of Michael Jackson's shoes from Travis Payne, and it was like the most amazing moment during rehearsals this week. So we talked all about that.
That's interesting.
Great.
Good tidbit.
AfterBuzz TV exclusive.
Right. We get all the exclusives here.
Jackie.
The stars come to talk with us. They're going to sit with us soon. I know that.
Yeah, I love it. What was interesting is Chelsea brought in Michael Jackson's choreographer.
Right.
Did you know him at all? Have you worked with
Travis?
Him?
Yeah. Oh, I know. Yeah. Travis, yeah.
No, the choreographer that worked with Michael Jackson.
Oh, yeah, Travis.
Travis was who was on tonight.
Oh, yeah.
And Travis is, he worked on This Is It with, you know, Kenny Ortega directed it, and they've all worked with Michael for years. Kenny, Travis is an amazing choreographer, and he's a great guy. He's a beautiful guy. He was there when you know, they were working on it when the tragedy happened with Michael. And so I heard everything kind of, you know, that had happened. I've known Travis for years, and it was really amazing to see him on the show tonight. I have to say, though, like, I'm so, I was so excited when I saw them do the dance. And just so you guys know, like, I worked with Michael Jackson. Yes, I did.
Did you really?
Yeah. I did his video, Blood on the Dance Floor.
Oh, my
gosh. So you can check it out. It's me with the red lips. I was actually wearing red lips in that, too. And I look like I look now, but it was like a million years ago.
You haven't aged at all.
And, come on. I saw both of your legs. It's a shame you can't see their legs behind the table.
I'll show you later.
One day we'll have a little
stick around.
Leg off.
The boobs you can see.
But it was amazing working with him, honestly, like... God, it was just like, it was, even, you know, then, it's like, I mean, it was just the most unique person, and he was so nice to everyone, and I'll just never forget that.
What an honor that you got to
learn. Yeah,
that's a memory you'll have for the rest of your life.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, I have to say, the one time I think I actually got a little teary tonight, Gavin.
Oh, my God.
With Karina.
Oh, my God.
When he told the story, you know, he danced to Billy Joel. He said that's when he realized that's what he wanted to do for his life. And when he was starting out, his dad went door to door telling people, my son is really good. Like, and then they cut to his dad in the audience. Like, just to feel like a parent loves their child so much. Like, it really hit me that
way. So much you can tell and see the support, you know?
And what's amazing about it is... It was so touching, the story, but then he was so sexy tonight. He was sexy. He was Gavin Fever. Come on, people.
That's what Carrie said. She had Gavin Fever.
I was like, oh, he's cute. You know, he's going to get the cute vote. But this week...
Yeah, I think I'll be having Gavin.
Yeah, a little bit. I think he was sexy.
We might have to fight you for that.
I saw him on the red carpet, too. I was like...
He hugged us both.
Yeah, but he's an amazing performer. I mean, I just think he's such a great artist. But seeing him perform tonight was so great.
It was a nice start, too, on the piano with him sitting there. Yeah. Like, it really set the whole tone.
And
you're right, he moved.
Karina should get some credit for, I think she choreographed an amazing dance.
She did. And, I mean, let me tell you, that girl, she's like modern-day Sid Charisse to me as a dancer. I watch her and I'm just like, I mean, I cannot wait. Hopefully, I think she just walked in to talk to her tonight.
Karina here?
I think I just saw her. She is seriously like, that girl is one of the most beautiful dancers I've ever seen. So for Gavin to have her as a partner, wow.
Yeah. He really transformed this week.
Yeah.
He also was so emotional when they were doing the scoring, he couldn't even speak.
I know.
I've never seen that in the history of Dancing with the Stars.
It was like
that when they were backstage and Brooke was trying to talk to him,
God.
He literally could not speak.
Yeah, it was so beautiful.
And you can tell that he wasn't doing it for anything other than it truly came from right in here.
Yeah.
And you can see that when somebody might be playing it up or, and it just came from such a deep place that that added to the sexiness, Gavin.
It did. And he partnered Karina so, like, eloquently and perfect, and everything was... it's like, it's hard to do when you're working with such an incredible dancer.
You know what I mean?
Like, to be the partner for Karina to let him, there she is.
We're waving at Karina.
Yeah, we're talking about you.
Talking about you, Karina.
But for Karina to let him partner her, you know, because it's easy for someone like her to kind of
find out. Oh, we got her to come.
Things about you.
We're literally on you and Gavin talking about your dance.
Did they just show us?
No, we were
just talking about it.
Yeah, couple talking about the dances, and we're up to you and Gavin.
What did you think?
Basically, we were saying not only was it one of the most emotional highlight of the night, his whole story and the fact that he was so sensitive about it and his dad in the audience, but you're also one of the best female dancers on the show.
So yeah. I have named you. Truly the Sid Charisse of our time. I mean,
I love you.
She's the most beautiful. I'm so inspired by her. And I was watching you tonight, and I told your publicist, I said, like, she's Sid Charisse. I mean, she was, you know, she danced with everyone from Fred Astaire, Gene Kelly, every amazing dancer. And you, the way you move in your body and your legs, it's like, it's so unbelievable.
Really?
Yeah. Seriously.
It's really interesting because she's my idol. Like, if people ask me, like, who do you look after? And I always say Sid Charisse. And when I came to L.A., it was 2006, after season 3 of Dancing with the Stars, I did a whole tribute at Hollywood and Highland for Sid Charisse.
Really?
And she came, so I got to meet her. You know, she passed away recently, but... Like, to me, it's probably the biggest compliment ever.
One of my favorite that I would love to see you do is the dance in Singing in the Rain that she does with Gene Kelly.
Yes.
She's in the green dress. Like, oh my God, like, I could see you just, like, owning that.
It's interesting because Fred Astaire was known to be partnered with Ginger Rogers for the most part.
Yeah.
But he's, from what the rumor is, his favorite partner was Sid Charisse because he said, you know, she might have done a wrong turn or the foot wasn't turned out fully, but she lived every moment
of it. Oh my God. And that's how you are, seriously. Like, I can't, it's hard when you're dancing with someone else because I can't take my eyes off of you.
Yeah.
As the dancer, it's really amazing.
You, Corey, we were just saying, and you know as a choreographer, that you choreographed the perfect story tonight to really give Gavin a chance, I think. I saw it in your work as well to make him shine and really bring out the emotion for him. And that was just really amazing. Like, to start him, Rachel, you were saying to start him at the piano like that.
Yeah,
I mean, those
really
are just great choices.
There were actually two reasons for that.
Oh, really?
Tell us, please. Okay, the first reason was the fact that he is a piano player as well as a singer-songwriter. So for him, that's his comfort zone. And that's where he comes from, and that's where he's going to go to. But the second reason is, I think a lot of us have the pretty woman scene as a fantasy.
Oh, yeah.
And I got to relive mine.
Yes, definitely.
Oh, I'm sure.
The best. Now, how'd you get those hips to move tonight?
He's got amazing movement.
He was sexy. He was sexy tonight.
What did you do to the poor guy?
Well, we worked on the hip action a lot. That's true. But his hips are... No.
On the piano?
Okay, tell us.
right out of the scene, yes. No, we actually did spend a lot of time on hip action because he does have flexibility.
Yeah.
And you know how, like, the judges said week one that he was a little stiff?
Yes.
I was actually saying to him throughout the whole time, get stiffer because he's soft. So I just said, let your hips do the talking and leave the rest of the body stable, and he listened to it.
Exactly, because it's hard to understand both of those against each other. Like, stiff but soft, what does that mean? You know, and
it's
great. You're such a great teacher, and you can tell the progression is amazing. I mean, he went from being completely stiff to a dancer, and I was saying it must be so hard, like, because, you know, he's partnering you, and you're so amazing. Like, you let him partner you. You know what I mean? And you really have this amazing connection.
The things that you pick up on is unbelievable, by the way. Because the whole week...
She knows a thing or two.
Yeah. but it's the details. We worked this week so hard. I said, I need you to know the dance well enough that you are in the driver's seat, not following me. Be the leader that you are. And he embraced it, because every time he leads, you could see, like, as a guy, he's like
there's
so much power in when you see the the guy as the you know, the celebrity leading someone like you, when you see that, and like, I was just like, wow, he's really leading her, you know, because I know how it is, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, obviously we always want to lead, but like, just having that, you know, but yeah, exactly.
Did you get
a
chance?
Talk about that. We're all control freaks, you know.
Did you get a chance to talk to his dad after the performance?
I did. I met his father 3.5 years ago when we first met with Gavin. And I remembered it later when we were in Nashville, when Gavin was still touring, his dad and his mom came out, and he reminded me, and I'm like, that's right. Super sweet family. They just celebrated their 40th anniversary. His grandparents are here. And to me, like, you know, he comes from a strong family. Family that's still together. Like, you know, I don't want to sound like pessimistic, but it's hard. In our generation, it's just hard.
It's
not as
very
common.
Rare.
So, like, and for him, this is so important. That's why having his dad help him in his career and, you know, being there 100% and then sitting in the audience crying, it's, I always get emotional.
I know, but it is emotional. It's like, I was saying, dance brings out so much emotion and passion, and, you know, and we were saying how, you know, Jackie was asking, like, do you think they're able to use it, you know, does it come out? And it's like, it does. I mean, that's what it's all about. It's all about everything. You know, you begin to love your partner in whatever way that is, but it's like, it's just because you have the connection is so powerful when you're dancing together.
Well, it's a great song brings out emotions through lyrics and music, great acting through the way they act the scene out. Yeah. So dancing is the same thing, and sometimes, sometimes you rehearse and I was like, Gavin, wow.
Yeah.
Like, you're really hot. Then I'm thinking, that's Gavin. Like, you go back and forth.
Yeah,
I think
true.
You and Gavin really epitomize what the show is about. You know, seeing the real growth in someone, watching him become a dancer.
That's true.
It's a really nice thing to see. Ninth of Grant had to take down William and Catherine.
No, you're on your way there. I mean, to be so sexy tonight and the outfit, everything. I mean, I just really...
I'm undressing him slowly. It's really tough. I said, would you be comfortable maybe if we're still around in a couple of weeks, maybe do a wife beater? He's like, well, maybe in a couple of weeks. We got the jacket off, so.
Speaking of bodies, I have a question. I think a lot of people would want to hear this. What do you do outside of the show for your body? Do you have a ritual or do you just sort of feel
it? I give myself cheat days. I always do because I can't. You know how some people are so strict and they literally eat what they preach?
Yeah.
I can't do that.
Yeah.
I would have, you know, a burger once in a while. I'd go for a Sunday. So I got to give myself those cheat days because you look forward to them then.
Yes.
Right.
And you work that much harder in between.
Yeah.
But I have a Shape Up fitness class. It's less dancing. It's more fitness. It's about 45 to 50 minutes of full cardio and workout. So when I teach that class, it's a great workout.
Oh, that's great.
For me.
We want to go.
Oh, you've got to come.
This is out here.
I have a studio in Woodland Hills.
Oh, wow.
I'm in Ventura, so I teach there.
We should shoot some AfterBuzz.
Yeah.
Studio. Us doing a dance class.
Oh, that would be awesome.
I would want to come. Can we do that?
I would love to.
That would be amazing.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
We
can do a class.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So I do that, and I do love Bikram yoga.
Do you?
I know, the sweat.
It's instant gratification. An hour and a half, and you stand in the puddle of your own sweat.
Yeah.
Right. But you feel really good.
The heat feels so amazing on your muscles, you know?
Well, on that note, we are going to definitely plan to come see you.
Yes, thank you.
We will be seeing you many weeks, too.
Yay, because you
and Gavin are going nowhere. We always love having you on AfterBuzz.
Thank you
so much, Karina.
And I'll be seeing you in Pussycat Doll Land very soon.
Yes.
We love you.
One of our favorites, for sure.
Yay.
Thank you,
Karina.
That was so perfect. We were just talking about
it. I know.
Fate, ladies, fate.
Oh, my gosh.
That's a hard one to top.
I know.
The next dancers weren't Catherine and Mark.
Oh, my God, I know.
Another emotional highlight of the show. I mean, she had lost her dad when she was younger. This was obviously something very painful and difficult for her.
Right. Wow.
And it clearly came out in the dance. I mean, I can't remember which judge, maybe Carrie Ann, was like, you were dancing not only with Mark, but with your dad.
Carrie Ann couldn't even hold up. I mean, she was so emotional.
You know what I thought was really admirable, though, was she kept her composure through the dance. As a woman, I feel like it's different for men. I feel like they have it... It's easier for them to keep their emotions, not obviously tonight, not based on tonight with the men, but for her, I feel like she broke down after it was over, but for a woman, I think she kept her composure through the performance.
Yeah, I think that I will say, you know, when whatever you're going through, when you start dancing, it's like something else kicks in.
Right.
That you almost go into this other place. That's what's so amazing about dancing, that it's like therapy, and it brings you to another plane.
That's what this felt like this week, yeah. Right? Like a therapy session
yeah.
for everybody?
And then when it's over, it's like
I definitely needed a drink right after.
Yeah.
Or three.
And I ate french fries.
Yeah. I know. The only thing I have to say is, and this might be controversial, but I think she's beautiful. I think she's like Grace Kelly, and she, her dance was beautiful. I did not find the choreography that difficult in this dance.
Agree.
I just was surprised that she got the 10s because it just didn't think it was quite there yet.
There
Robin,
wasn't...
I defer to you on this.
Well,
yes.
No, that it, what I thought was it was beautiful, but there were it was like the steps were all kind of, they were just moving around the floor, but there was really nothing, you know, different, or there wasn't anything like down on the floor, or there wasn't any maybe sort of soft lift, or there wasn't anything that was anything almost to judge other than it was simple, and that's exactly what Len said, and I agree with that, and I think the audience went crazy because she is so beautiful and she deserves her scores because she's so good. But if you're scoring on week to week, it's not about last week or the week
right.
before. This scoring should have been about this week, and I personally would have given her a lower score.
Right. Well, here's what I noticed, not with the choreography background, but what I noticed is there was no move for me that, like with Maria's move at the end,
right.
where that was that camera work over the spin. Obviously, you know the technical terms.
You know that spin thing?
Yeah, the spinny thing. There was no move like that for me in this routine, which
yeah.
I guess can talk to what you guys are saying. It was fluid and it was pretty. And it was emotional, but there was no, like, move where... I think every other dancer tonight had, like, a move that I went, wow. I didn't notice a move in this routine.
Well, even Len said he thought Mark should have done more
right.
choreography
he called
and
him out
hold.
For that.
Like,
I
was the only one that was real about
right.
that. I thought that Bruno and Carrie Ann were too soft.
Yeah.
And
it,
I got too taken in with the emotional part of it.
I was just going to say, here's the debate on that... the way that the judges judge on the choreography, because it's not the celebrity's fault. So
yeah,
true. So when they say there was no choreography, well, it's not Catherine's fault. And God, I love Mark more than anything, but I don't know why he chose to make it so simple. So how do you score that? You know, like that's something that is interesting.
Based on her Twitter this week, she was tweeting that she was having a difficult time with it. And then one day she tweeted that she had a breakthrough. It's possible maybe he changed it throughout the week. Is that possible? That maybe
they always change. I know
right.
like Derek changes choreography as
yeah.
they go along with Maria.
Right.
Which makes it a little tougher on the celebrity.
Yeah, but the thing is, as the weeks build, I know for me, if I'm choreographing week to week, I'm going to want to make it harder and harder, and I'm going to want to make it a little bit more challenging for the celebrity, and even if they're injured or anything, there's got to be something in there that's got to be like just something to let us grab onto, and I truly believe in this dance there was not one thing other than it was beautiful.
Okay. Well, that's always good, though. I mean,
well,
it's not the worst
thing. We can agree
in the
that
world.
She's beautiful. You
right.
guys, I feel like we're on such a downer tonight because of all this. Where's our dance party? Each week you have to teach us a new move.
Oh yeah, right.
Last week it was like this one. What do we got today? Give us one.
So we'll start
so we can like
start
get the booty something to uplift a little bit.
Down and up.
Woo.
And.
You guys definitely gotta go to YouTube and check this out.
I feel like we're in the scene in Legal Illusion.
Yeah,
no,
it's all
Legally Blonde.
We're the
where she's teaching
we're
her how to
and
pick
snap.
Up the pencil.
Yeah.
One.
Okay.
Okay.
Shimmying.
Woo! I like it. We're getting our own dance. I really want to go take Karina's. What do you think? Should we all do that?
We have to do that.
Okay.
No, seriously.
We're going to do a class at Karina's Dance Studio and report back to you guys on that one.
I want to go tomorrow.
But that's the funny thing about tonight is it was such a different energy. Like, even with Sherry Shepherd, who I know is next.
Oh, my God. Yes.
She is somebody who we love because because she's so bubbly and effervescent. And even for me to watch her tonight, I was like,
that really is a miracle. I mean, her baby's so premature.
I know. The story's amazing.
Paralyzed, cerebral palsy, like so many things. They weren't even sure that her son was going to live.
Right.
And here he is, like, we see him every week in the studio, her
looking
son.
Adorable.
The cutest thing ever, dancing in his seat, so proud of his mom.
So cute.
I mean, that's actually a really feel-good story.
It is. The story is so beautiful, and it makes you love her and get to know her even more. But let's get to the dance, because that's why we're here.
Uh-oh.
And I have to say that I understand, you know, with this dance that we're not going to see her shimmying and shaking, but I still would have given her something, some kind of an accent, something that would have let us, have that, like, whoa!
But she was doing the rumba. It's kind of hard, right? Like,
But something, I just felt like it was, I don't know, like it wasn't, wasn't my favorite.
Even in that moment where she started to smile a little bit, it didn't really match the dance.
I mean,
so
listen, Maria.
It wasn't her dance, though.
Maria was doing the rumba. Maria was on a different level as far as the choreography, as far as the way that she executed the choreography. Again, could have been in the choreography, but the way that she executed it was like she was feeling it in her hips. And I think with Sherry, it just, she's got those hips and she's got that body. And we said last week she was the most dynamic of all time. But there was something about tonight that it felt very matronly. And maybe it was also in her hair and her costume.
It was out of her comfort zone.
I think it was her in a way that she showed her emotion genuinely. But you could tell that she didn't sign up to do that dance. She signed up to do last week's dance.
I think she signed up to do her first week's dance.
And that.
And the last week was the Tina Turner.
Tina Turner, that was
unbelievable.
I think that Sherry is a smart enough woman as a dancer on the show. I mean, because I know she's not a dancer, but like, I can relate where if I were given that exact choreography and that hair and that costume, which I would have told them I'm not wearing, just because I would have, but, you know, I would have worked it in a way that you would have known that I would have given you that sex and that thing. And I feel like she made it too light. And there's a difference there that it just, that doesn't work for the audience.
Well, last week Sherry told us she practiced her dance in her birthday suit for her husband.
That's right.
Do you think she practiced this one again?
I know.
I don't know how that one would go.
I know. It's very, my point exactly.
It doesn't really warrant the birthday suit. I don't know. That would just be kind of creepy, maybe.
But now if Maria did it for her man,
oh, that
in
would
her
be one
suit,
lucky guy.
I'm telling you, there
whoever
you go.
Maria's man been hot. Is.
Oh yeah. Boy,
he's a hot tamale.
He really is. Maria's man
he's
is
a
quite
man.
A looker.
He's
that one.
Those two together, boy. Watch out.
Okay, one of the things that I find really unbelievable this season is that Melissa Gilbert broke her back a year and a half ago.
Oh, yeah.
The fact that she is walking, standing, bending, twirling.
Insane.
I mean, Robin, as a dancer, like, how much is it, how difficult is that
well,
to come
it's,
back from?
It's close to a miracle. I mean, it's, you know, when you break your back, I mean, the chances of coming back to literally even walk is a miracle. So the fact that she's dancing and moving her body and shaking it and doing all of that is like, I think it's, I was blown away when I heard that story. And I didn't know that story because I obviously we've all grown up with her. And she...
How ironic, though, is that she broke it on the set of The Little House
I
on
know,
the Prairie musical.
Know.
Like, and that thing just haunts her whole life.
Exactly. It's like, okay, stop with Little House. But she looked beautiful tonight, and I like that she really, you know, you could feel she really went for it, and she was just, she's ready to just let it all hang out. Now, the only thing I will say is that her shoulders are still up here. And that, for me, I noticed the second she started her dance, shoulders are too high. And I was surprised that all of the judges didn't notice any of it or didn't judge it. Karianne is always the one right away to say, shoulders up, too high,
also a lack of energy in the legs. Dead weights a little bit. I think tonight the judges were kind of taking it easy based on the emotion. Jackie.
I think so, and I also think that for me, she's great. I don't want to mean this as a negative to her, but compared to the other dancers this season who are just so good, she's maybe one who's, when I watch her, I don't think she quite brings it as much as these other contestants.
Do you think that she's going to be the one to go?
Honestly, the question everybody was asking in the press room tonight is who is going to go home from this group?
It's a tough one.
And that's why I don't want to say her. I would never wish that on her.
Yeah.
But it's hard because she's maybe one that jumps out in my brain as a possibility only because everybody else is so good.
Yeah.
It's a tough
call. Although I miss Max. Where is he?
I know.
Because he's being an asshole.
And he said he's not going to challenge the judges this season. That's what we want you to do. That's
why
we like you back.
How good is he without that?
Well, why wouldn't he want to do that?
I mean, his shirt is open. Okay, thank you.
He's just not as sexy when he's not being bad.
He's got to be bad.
I like him bad.
Melissa turned him into a good boy. I think he cried at the Lion King is what I read in his blog.
Are you serious?
Yep.
Really?
He admitted that he cried over the Lion King. He's turning totally soft this season.
Yeah, we don't like it.
Max. Come back, Max.
Max,
want
you
gotta
come talk to us. Come on the panel with the ladies.
That's right.
But
we'll
wrap
you up a bit.
Robin will.
Let me tell you, let's get him in here for one. Where is he?
Will you let him touch your boobs?
Yes. Come on, Max. Help me with my dress. It's falling off. But based on Melissa's performance tonight and last week, I'm not so sure about her. Her sticking
that
around.
One's definitely up in the air.
Not to say that she's not great. She's doing a great job.
Absolutely, but when it comes down to it, this is about winning. This is about being the best. And you know, she's beautiful, and her story is unbelievable. But it's about what can you bring, and can you be better than everyone else? And there are too many good people on this season.
Well, one of our favorites too, who always comes by and chats with us, is Mr. Jaleel Urkel. Yes. Did he keep calling himself Urkel?
Urkel.
Was that the name of his character?
Stefan Urkel, ladies.
That was the real name?
It's the alter ego.
Stefan Urkel.
Alter ego.
Steve Urkel. Stefan Urkel is when he goes into the transformation chamber and he comes out cool. And
that what happened on the show?
Yes.
We were like,
do you watch Nick at Night?
I clearly have
no.
If you put Nick at Night on at 5 in the morning, you will see Stefan Urkel. He's the alter ego.
5 in the morning? Oh, my goodness. Wow.
And
you're getting crazy, Jackie.
He's the cool version. So, Laura fell in love with him because he came out as, the cool guy. He ended up staying as Stefan Urkel.
Really?
Yes.
Good to know.
People?
Okay. I was very confused. We kept going, what? Urkel? What? Is he, renaming himself?
Obviously, the executive producers came up with it, which you might have thought he went to them and asked them, can I be cool in a few episodes? But they came up with it, and he said he wasn't sure if he could do it.
Oh, look at Antin in their ass! Woo! Meninos are ravishing.
Oh, my God, and
Gavin Fever.
Sexy Gavin.
We have a serious case of Gavin Fever, baby.
Sexy Gavin.
Come on, put your butt down there.
Juice box into a glass. So it would be
can you put those headphones over your hat?
We need some juice up here.
Now, Gavin, Karina was telling us that the reason for the piano is because she wanted her own pretty woman scene. What do you have to say about that, Gavin?
I almost salt peppered my hair and had her call me Richard. she was pretty adamant about that particular scene. I think it may be her favorite movie of all time. And she said it was every woman's fantasy, excluding me.
Seriously.
Well,
she wanted more body hair and skin.
Right.
And,
we heard you might wear a wife beater if you stick
around.
Yeah,
she's getting your clothes off.
I often wear one of those.
We want more skin every week.
You wore a wife beater last week.
Yeah,
not in the show, no.
Oh.
No, Just Maria gets rehearsal.
To see the wife beater.
Yeah. Well, we don't get to see that. Now, Gavin, your story and inspiration tonight was one that really moved us the most. Wow. With your dad and the fact that he went door to door. I mean, how much did that mean tonight?
It meant everything. You know, I know the situation I had in my family is rare, and that's why I appreciate it so much. You know, growing up, not everybody had that around me, and it meant the world to me. I grew up in a place that didn't really offer, well, any opportunity, and I just wanted to get out, and they gave me the keys, you know, so. That's the way it works.
It's amazing. Yeah. It's so amazing to have that support.
Yeah.
And you can see it with your family, you know, and seeing your dad. And
Dad, that's
heard.
So emotional.
Yeah, but it was so beautiful, you know. Like, it really is. And amazing, we heard that your parents are still together. And
Yeah. Actually, you know, this week's their 40th anniversary.
Amazing.
Happy anniversary.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Isn't that cool? And
yeah.
I flew out my grandparents also, and they've been married 62 years.
Wow.
And,
so cute.
Yeah, so it's a big week. We've been having a nice
awesome.
Yeah, Karina was saying she
nice
loves
time.
How much of a family man you are.
Thank you. I love my family. We're very lucky to have a great family. Maria has a wonderful family as well. And
honestly,
I'm no holy roller, but that really makes a big difference on people's lives. You know, giving them a little bit of background and. It gives them a rock to stand on when there's a storm, and there's a lot of storms out there.
Yeah. Maria, you also dedicated yours to your parents. It's also such an amazing story. Most people don't know that.
I actually dedicated to my parents and Kevin. Did they cut Kevin out?
Yeah, I don't know if Kevin made the cut.
Did they cut you out?
But we've been discussing what a lucky guy he is.
Can't allow that.
My favorite part is I said to Kevin, I said, I know you're not going to be in the audience this week, but you have to be, and I didn't tell him why. But that was why. I love how they always just conveniently cut you out, honey.
Yeah, that is so funny. Well, after you're making out with Derek on the show, they don't exactly want to show your boyfriend.
Well, my favorite is, I said, I would like to dedicate this dance to my parents and to Kevin, all of whom without, I would not be here today, which is true. They did the first half, he's done the last half. I haven't watched the package. I wasn't allowed to listen because Derek told me it would make me cry.
Oh, that's bad.
And so, honey, so you know, I did dedicate it to you. And
it did.
Kevin's the man.
Clearly, they didn't like the idea that Kevin was involved, I guess.
Well, you know.
He's used to getting cut.
Just because they want all those hot men out there thinking that, you know, Maria's single, whatever.
You're not single? I'm out of here.
Sexy going on tonight. I mean,
Derek
is like lying on top of her, practically making out. You with the hips. I mean, I don't even know where those came from.
Hips.
Yeah,
oh, and they've always had them. Apparently, Karina says you've always had them.
Thank you.
And you've brought them out tonight.
Oh, that's nice of her. Actually, I moved my hip actually so far to the right at one point. I thought I might have left my leg behind.
I mean, you really. Like, but we were saying the progress was
right?
So incredible.
Both of you.
I saw him over there.
Most
by
people,
the way,
like, you're a rock. You're like a rocker. You know, you're a guy that people are never gonna think is gonna be able to get up here and do this kind of dancing. I think you've got to be a huge inspiration, really, for men.
For all men who wear leather
who
pants.
Think,
out
yeah,
there.
They go, wait, I don't dance, and then they go, wait, but Gavin dances.
But that's what I said when I walked in. I said I was so proud of you because. I feel like Gavin and I were like in cahoots from the beginning. The two of us were both terrified.
Cahoots?
Yeah.
We had a plan.
We had a plan to try to survive it together. And to see him do so well, I was so happy.
You
like
too.
Derek and I were cheering so hard for him up there.
You too.
And I got so emotional when I saw him in the entryway. I'm like, we both did well.
You did. Well, yeah, we were saying with you, Maria, because like, you're like the tomboy, like we all know you as like this like cool tough chick, you know, wrestling, the crazy laugh, the, you know, like you're like, and then you're out there like the most elegant, just you know, the way that you move, your body, everything is just so beautiful. I mean, it's crazy.
Yeah. Are you crying because you're still emotional, or your ribs hurt?
Everything hurts. Everything hurts.
Everything
yes.
hurts. I'm crying because everything hurts.
But the title of your next song, Gavin.
Yeah. I have to say, no, just before I walk.
watched it on YouTube.
Yeah.
And I got so emotional because I said, growing up, like, I wanted to do all those things. I wanted to go to dance class. Yeah. My parents couldn't afford that. So, yeah, I ended up going to work with them. And it's not boo-hoo me. I'm so thankful that that's how I grew up. But it means so much to me now to be able to have this opportunity.
To know what it feels like to be a dancer.
Yeah, like, I can't wait to, like, tell Derek, like, wow, I watched it and I'm so incredibly proud of it.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's so inspiring,
great.
You know?
Do you feel like this week you could both walk off the stage and truly just be proud of what you did up there?
100%.
Yeah.
Absolutely not.
100%.
I'm not going anywhere.
You need to win it, Jackie.
I don't want to go anywhere.
Walk off the stage. No, I mean tonight when you walked off the stage. We don't want either of you leaving us.
We don't
want
to leave.
I don't want to go anywhere.
We don't want you to leave either.
We don't want anyone to leave.
I feel like I accomplished tonight what I wanted to accomplish.
Especially the kiss.
Agreed.
The sexy rumba was the thing I was the most scared of because I didn't know that I could, like, let go. Sean, my acting coach, knows how terrified I am of, like, letting go. And I watch it back and I let go and I performed and it was like all the little things, like the sitting
detail,
in the camp, all the details that I wasn't getting in different places that I got, and I just wailed like a little
girl. I was so proud of you. Like, honestly, all the little things that we worked on, the hands, the fingers.
I know, Robin had, like, a mini pep session with me. She was like, listen, you gotta, like, feel it. You gotta, like,
I was giving her all that.
And I knew she was the one to, like, put it over the top with me because we did the Pussycats all together. I knew she could help. Even just being around her and watching her be sexy, I was like, all right. And you know what? It's funny. Do you know what I thought of before I went out there? My last two rehearsals, I'm like, I gotta bring the sexy, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, I almost performed Fever when I did the Pussycat
House. Yeah. She has a great voice, by the way. She was singing Fever, and then she canceled it at the last second and just danced. But her voice is amazing.
Oh, man.
I know.
I kept singing it in my head and feeling, like, that whole emotion so that I could get in the mood.
Oh, that's so
Maria,
great.
The entire time, the guy sitting next to me was going, damn, that girl is working her dress. It's working that track, like, over and over and over. And I was laughing.
It was so funny.
He was so into you and the dress and the whole thing.
Did you get the tip when you guys were walking off in rehearsal?
Get
I'm
the
like,
what?
Yeah.
Get the what?
The leg.
The leg.
The what?
Oh,
what? What? Can't say that.
The what?
Gavin, I want to know what helps you get sexy.
The leg thing, when I said lift up your knee, and you were walking up, I'm like, Derek, tell her to lift up her knee.
I know, because I was afraid. I thought I had to be a plank, and she's like, no. She's like, feel it. I was like, oh, all right. Well, I wanted to do it, but I was afraid to.
Yeah. Jackie has a good question.
Yeah, now we know how you got sexy tonight. We have help from Robin, but Gavin, you got really sexy tonight, and I want to know
who helped you.
Who helped you get sexy?
And do you need more help?
Yeah.
Mostly, I think my tailor is to thank.
That was a great outfit.
It was a great tailor.
Yeah, you looked really
very James Bond. Sexy.
He gave me some hot. I think they call them at the tuxedo store, butt huggers.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, your buns.
But the women appreciate it.
Yeah, they look nice.
Did it help to start at the piano for you? Did that bring a comfort zone?
Actually, yeah, it did bring a comfort zone. Obviously, definitely, but as comfortable as it made me to be at the piano first, still the most comfortable part of the dance was the piano bench. It had a cushion.
Something serious.
Yeah, it really helped me. It was very nice. It was tufted, and anyway, it did help. It was a tufted bench.
You know interior design, I see.
I do. I enjoy the design. I used to work at a magazine stand, so we sold Architectural Digest.
Oh, I love it. That's great.
You both have these kind of American dream big stories.
Yeah.
Where can you even look back now and think to where you were when you were listening to Material Girl, or think to going door to door?
We just had a conversation. I won't, that's right. I won't say everything, but it's your next song. Absolutely.
Serious.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was having a conversation just before with Maria.
We should do it together.
Yeah, Exactly. And about it's not just about getting where you're going, but it's really important as you're getting there to just take those moments and look back and see where you were. And you got to be able to say, there I was, you know, and otherwise you won't be able to appreciate where you're at and where you're headed.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
I had a moment like that today. It's a special thing. In many ways we're living a fairy tale, you know, and
100%.
I definitely have some rags to riches stories here, and it's very special in that way.
Hard work is behind that fairy tale, though, too.
Loads of hard work, but the most important element of it is being able to appreciate it, you know?
Yeah.
If you can't appreciate it, it may as well not exist. So, being able to take a step back and go, wow, you know, look at what's happening with my life, and look at these people, what they've accomplished, and wow, look at the company I'm in, and being able to say to yourself and see that you're representing something that you were told existed, but almost no one saw it happen, you know, like very few people experience seeing their dreams come true, you know?
Right.
And
what's incredible, speaking of accomplishment, is we had Karina over here before, and she happens to be, you know, she's truly, I think, one of the most amazing dancers on the show.
Sure.
One of the most amazing women, one of the most amazing dancers I've ever seen. And I told her, I said, she's like a modern day Cerise. You know, she's just got that elegance, that grace, that just the way she moves her body. And you happen to be with her.
She can shake that butt like there's no tomorrow.
She's so hot, but you partnered her.
Can I interrupt?
Killed it.
Thank you very much.
You did. Like, I'm telling you, I said to her,
you dominated
the fact
her.
That
like,
you,
that was a major
yeah,
turning
like,
point.
It's so hard
Big
to partner
time.
Someone like her, because immediately she's going to want to partner you. And you had her, like, you, it was, seriously, I was
she's
really
making little eyes
because I was watching that.
You're very sweet. I was going to ask that you not give her any more compliments, please, because I have to work with this person.
I know. That head's swelling.
With you, hold on, we're all jealous.
Yeah.
Because you should have seen how controlling she was when I was driving her car the other day.
I'm sure.
And she was like, left turn, Clyde.
Right?
And, you know, like,
yeah, I'm
slow
sure
down, man. Use your blinkers. You know? So,
yeah.
The that's, more you tell her about how great she is, the more control she's going to want to take.
I know.
That makes it very
so
difficult.
So, are you madly in love
man.
Yet? Come on.
Going to have a conversation about the direction of our relationship. We need to discuss the nature of our association.
Association, that's
important.
A new one.
Now, we I'm cannot curious. Tell you how much we love watching you both dance.
Both of
thank
you.
You.
I mean, you guys are both in it for the long haul.
We're making our prediction.
And I want to know
we're secretly crushing on you, Maria. You know, it's just beyond.
I want to see you guys dance
amazing.
Together.
Yes.
Yeah.
We haven't
a
had
duet.
That conversation yet.
Yeah.
We'll take a duet. Or will you dance to one of your songs if
that
we
be,
are so lucky?
That would be, well, I'm flattered that you would like to see that. I'd be apprehensive to dance to one of my own songs, only because I'm a singer,
yeah.
And I've sung those songs thousands of times, and hearing someone else sing it might be distracting for me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, a little.
I know what you mean.
It would be like,
totally.
It would be like listening
well,
to somebody kiss the love
right,
of my
right,
life
right.
Or
you're
something.
Like, hold on a second, I'm going to leave the microphone and I'm going to go dance now.
Yeah.
It's something different, yeah.
No, well, anyway, thank you so much for joining us. We are continuing to root for you guys.
You guys are awesome. Thank you very much.
Yeah, we're huge supporters of both of you.
Thank you guys so much. Vote for Maria Menounos.
Yeah.
And Gavin, keep bringing those hips every week, would you?
Seriously.
And the tight pants.
Oh.
Yeah, we like it.
And take off your shirts.
just get completely undressed.
And take everything else off, too.
Yeah, just take it all off.
We all want our pretty ones.
Dancing with the nude stars.
That's a good twist.
Nude stars.
Gavin, I hate to tell you, but your drink looks very girly compared to Maria's drink.
We have water.
If we were drinking serious spicy.
Yeah, where's our drink?
I don't know what you're talking about. This is unleaded.
Now we have to get back to talking about people that weren't nearly as good as you guys.
Oh.
Like that William Levy character.
I like the way you think.
William Levy's got nothing on you. You've got better abs, better shape.
when I was told William Levy might take off his shirt, they're like, what would you do if he takes off his shirt? I was like, I offer to launder his shirt. I'd be happy to get his shirt laundered.
Exactly. I'm gonna go get another
beer. If he takes it off,
yeah. I earned it. All
right, you guys, roll. Go have some cocktails.
See you guys later.
We will see you in a few minutes.
Sign off.
Love you, Maria.
See you guys.
Bye, Gavin.
Bye, guys. Well, two really great, great stories. Tonight.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Love them.
Yes, I got the high five. I got a good high five because I'm generally a bad high five.
Anymore.
At some point during this thing, will you serenade us? Not just
yes.
To be tonight, but one
at
time while you see us sitting at this panel, will you serenade us?
Gavin!
Oh, baby,
he's gonna do it.
Oh
my God, he's gonna do it. He's gonna sing for us.
Oh my God, Gavin,
yeah! This is like Beatlemania.
Ready?
Woo!
Girls are gonna sing you a classic.
Okay.
Just sang you I Want to Sex You Up by Color Me Bad. Not gonna happen.
I'll dance to it.
Remember I Want to Sex You Up?
Oh yeah. I want to sex you up.
Hey! Don't stop.
I want to sex you up.
I don't remember the words right here.
I want to sex you up.
Gotta rhyme with the words of right here.
I want to sex you up.
That's the end of this song. See you later.
That he got like a traditional like Latin,
yeah,
hip
salsa,
shaking,
oh my god,
kind of, like there is no dance for Taylor.
Born to do that.
I mean, he literally, it just like it just came out of him.
It was like he just fell right into that, and it was like,
and all
it
he was, to do it was pull home. That shirt open. Come on,
yeah, that was it was home for him. The way that he moved, the way he moved his hips, his feet, the way that his hands were. He was a true. You couldn't have gotten better than he was in that dance.
Honestly, though, after this week, if he makes it through, which I'm not worried about, where is he going to go?
I know.
Well, it's tougher for him when he does the ballroom.
It is.
But can I tell you, there was a moment where I was like, awkward.
With
he's
the leg.
Talking about Cuba and how horrible it was for his family.
Oh, yeah.
And how poor, and his dad was a political prisoner and they escaped. And then Carrie Ann goes, I want to go to Cuba.
After that performance, that it just probably passed over a lot of our heads.
Yeah.
Let's hope for Carrie Ann's sake.
Now the issue with their dance was Cheryl, who's another amazing dancer who I just love, had problems.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. She's such a good dancer, and she knows how to get in and out of difficult situations. If there's trouble.
What happened there?
The thing is that it's hard to say because, I mean, I want to see it in slow motion, but she got, it's either his legs weren't wide enough, but when she went under his legs, she kind of like, she didn't slide, and I don't know what the choreography really was supposed to be. I think that it was that she was supposed to slide and then turn, but she kind of crept under. Like, I think she was worried that she couldn't fit, and that was probably his fault, but... I would think as Cheryl, she would have, I don't know.
I don't know.
Yeah, I was saying, I analyzed it.
But they definitely had an issue or two in terms of some of
the other one that you thought the issue, I don't think there was an issue.
There was, what did you think, Jackie? The one where her head kind of got
That's
caught?
What I thought.
I thought that was the issue. It did not look right to me.
I really hope that she comes here tonight.
It looked like she got a, she was in pain. And I did ask her on the red carpet, actually. She didn't go into too much detail, but I said something happened there that wasn't supposed to happen. She's like, right, that's true.
But I don't know if it was that. I'm going to find out, honestly, because
you
I
need
have
to
a
ask
feeling.
Cheryl. Hopefully she'll come by tonight. And they got the second highest score of the night.
Yeah.
Which is amazing.
Bruno, meanwhile, was like, come over here.
I know.
But then he gave him a 10, so I guess he could say whatever he wants.
I thought it was close to perfection. I really did.
Yeah. Okay, and finally, Donald and PETA.
Yeah.
Jackie, what did you think?
Honestly, I think Donald is, to me, one of my favorite competitors to watch in this competition because I really think he genuinely has such a drive behind it, and I don't mean that to be a pun, but he really wants this, I think. I think he really puts so much effort into it, and to hear him afterwards talk about his family on the red carpet and just what he's made of, and there's just so much about him that I love, and I think with athletes, we've talked about this, he just brings something, just such a level to the dance, and I think he did a great job closing out the show tonight. He said if he makes it through, he's going to show more tattoos.
Ooh.
I never even saw any tattoos.
He's got plenty more.
I want to see.
That we haven't seen yet.
Because again, he's being, such an intense athlete to be able to get on the dance floor and have that grace. That's so hard to do.
Well, the football players have such a history on the show. Like, they win or they come in second. I mean, what is it about football players, do you think, Robin, that makes them such great dancers?
I mean, I grew up dancing with one of my main dance teachers was a guy named Billy Goodson, and he was a football player for years before he started dancing. And I'm telling you, he's one of the most graceful dancers I've ever seen. He taught me how to dance, and he's, like, gorgeous, and it's weird. There's something about football that just, they have this kind of air about them, and I think that most of them don't even know it.
Right.
That's the interesting part. So we might see more and more football players coming on Dancing with the Stars, which would be really great because it's so the opposite of what you would expect. You think they're going to come on and they're going to be all bulky and you know what I mean?
I'm curious, though, if you guys noticed this with them. Did it look like PETA kind of tripped when she was going up the steps a little bit with her dress? Did you notice
that? I didn't notice.
Yeah, I'm sure there's
sometimes it's so hard to tell, too, with the dresses.
There's like these slips and trips, but I feel like it's more about the overall emotion of the performance.
Yeah.
And, you know, for him, you could tell that came from such a deep place.
Absolutely. Even with speaking of the dresses and the costumes, you know, for the female celebrities, that's a whole other part of this that they have when they're dancing, they have to navigate around their dresses. I mean, that's so hard. You know, men never have to deal with that.
Right.
So
I enjoy that Donald Driver.
I love him. I really do.
His story was sad too.
Yeah.
I can't believe how many sad stories are
that story.
Among this cast.
How about
it's almost like they went and cast people specifically. If you didn't have a tragedy, you're not invited on this cast.
Right.
I mean, the fact that he lost his best friend, introduced him to his wife, like, it was like...
When Brooke went to talk to him, he like, his face just went... Like, he couldn't even speak. It was so intense.
And he has such a beautiful family, and I think you would think that the story tonight would have been about something with the family maybe more, but to have it be that story with his friend was just... Oh my God.
Yeah, you can tell they were very close.
It's tough tonight because, I mean, we have to think about who's going to go home tomorrow night. And it's like, it was a really solid. I mean, I know who's not going home.
Yeah.
I know Catherine's not going home. William's not going home. Maria's not going home. But after that,
I don't think Donald
or Sherry.
Okay, let's. Is Jack?
Jack, Melissa.
Melissa.
What about Roshan? Because Roshan, why was he in Jeopardy last week? That was like,
I know, that's
mind-boggling.
Who else?
I don't know. I think it's Gladys Knight. You never know. I mean, she's a legend. She's great.
It's usually been so much more obvious to know who's
this
going
is
home.
Really a tough call, and I think whoever goes home.
So who thinks Melissa's going home?
Honestly.
I say it's between Jack and Melissa.
I don't think it's going to be Jack. I think with his story opening the show, I just don't see it being Jack. I really, for me, and this is such, it's not even fair to say, but for me, the only person I could kind of see going home is Melissa.
I think Melissa.
But she wasn't even in the bottom three last week.
I know.
It's like so hard.
I know. It's amazing. amazing. And I know, even she shouldn't go home. I'm just saying.
I agree.
I'm
but
to pick somebody
has to go home. So we have to kind of book it, all of them, and you know, it's a tough one. But you never know. It could be someone that could be a shocker.
We're gonna have to wait in suspense, ladies.
I mean, there's shockers on the show.
Well, tomorrow night we'll find out who gets eliminated. We'll see who's right, who's wrong.
Yeah,
and of course we will be back. Next
Can't
week,
wait.
Yes.
AfterBuzzTV.com. Check us out on iTunes, Twitter,
cute outfits.
All of our cute outfits.
That's right.
Last year,
doing our new move.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Let's do one. Let's put it together.
Down.
Woo!
I'm going to report you for Karina.
Woo!
Wait, Jackie and I are determined to be part of the Pussycat.
Oh, you will be. Trust me.
Anyway, thank you so much for watching. We will see you again next week. Live after Dancing with the Stars. We see week 4 next week, so it'll be getting more and more exciting. All right, thanks for watching.
Buzz you later.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
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 The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.